Hello and welcome to this video. Today I want to show you how to use normal powered up hubs as battery box, and the reason for this video is that there is a powered up battery box, there's this Technic battery box, but it's very expensive. It has two switches for two ports, so it works pretty well, but it costs 35 euros, which is very much for a battery box, and you can get the normal powered up hubs and the Control Plus powered up hubs for as low as 20 euros on Bricklink. So why spend 35 euros for a simple dumb battery box if you can spend 20 to 40 euros for a hub that's smart, that has more ports, that can be used with Bluetooth, but it can't be used as a dumb battery box, so it might not be for your use case. But that's not completely true, because in this video I will tell you how to use the smart hubs as a battery box. That way you don't have to spend 35 euro for a dumb battery box. You can buy a smart hub, you can use it as a battery box as long as you don't need more features, and you can improve on that later, or you can change what you want to do with it later and still have more options than with a normal battery box. But there are a few issues, because these hubs have just have one button, which means that we can't make a battery box like this with several switches for each port, because we have one button and this one button has to control everything. So we can't make speed control or stuff like that. There might be workarounds that you can do on your own if you're creative and if you can program in Python. Then you can program this hub to react on shakes, so you can beat this hub and then it can get faster or stuff like that. Or you can use sensors. I recommend this one because it has many features and you can use the sensor to control a motor. But in this video I will show you how to use these hubs as a simple dumb battery box that can only turn the motor on. And to be more precise, the functionality will be similar to this battery box. It's a bit older, it's from the old 9-volt system. But back then, you had this battery box where you could press one button and then the ray would have energy. You can't control the speed, you can't control the direction, you can only start a motor in one direction if you press this button. And we don't want to have a Bluetooth connection for that, because a battery box should or must work independently. It doesn't make sense to have a Bluetooth connection if you just want to move one motor forwards. And for that, we will use pybricks. Pybricks is a very useful tool, because these smart hubs are actually programmable. They have microcontrollers inside, which can be programmed, and you can store programs on them locally. So you won't need a Bluetooth connection. You can store a Python program on them locally, and then you can use the Python program without any further connection. And this Python program can be a simple battery box program. So we can use these smart hubs as a battery box. And I will show you a very simple program. You can always improve on that, but I want to stick to a simple example in this video. And I will use the pybricks IDE in this video. You can get that in the settings menu. Then with Chrome, you will have the option to download it on Mac, Windows, and Linux. So you can simply download it here. I downloaded it in the past, so I will use this. And here we have to activate an important option in the settings, because there is the option to include the current program in the firmware. Pybricks uses its own firmware to execute the Python programs, and normally you would type this code here and then you would execute it locally, or you would execute it directly via Bluetooth. But then the program wouldn't be stored on the hub. In order to store the program on the hub, it has to be included or integrated into the firmware, and that will be done if you activate this. So after you activated this, everything that's written in this code window here will be included into the firmware that you download to the hub. So you will always have to download the firmware again after you changed something in the program. But now let's start. First, we will have to include everything that we want to use. And you have to include everything manually. So you can include the modules manually, you can include the sensors manually. But there's a small workaround. I will simply use the command from pybricks dot pup devices, powered up devices, import star. This will import everything in powered up devices. So we won't have to import every powered up device, every motor and every sensor manually. Next, we can import the ports because you want to tell the hub which port we want to use. So we can import from pybricks.parameters import port. And this doesn't really work good. So it should look like this. Let me check if I made any errors. I don't think so. Next, we have to tell the program that we want to use a motor and which plug we plug the motor in, or which plug we use for the motor. We can check this documentation. And there are two different classes for motors. There's the class for DC motors. DC motors are motors without rotation sensors. And there's the class for motors with rotation sensors. So make sure that you use the right class. Use the DC motor class for both of these motors and the normal motor class for all of the other motors. In my case, I want to use the normal motor with a rotation sensor, so I will have to use the normal motor class. And now I have to think of a name for the motor. I will simply call it motor equals to motor, but this motor has to be large because it's the name of the class. And then we have to tell the program the port of the motor. In my case, it's port B. So it will know that I plugged a motor in port B, and we can access the motor on port B with this command. We could also add another motor. Let's call it motor 2 on port A. And then we have to activate the motor. Oh, and make sure to write DC motor if your motor doesn't have a rotation sensor. But now we have to activate the motor. We have to tell the motor how fast it should go. And that can be done with this motor. So we use the name that we gave to the motor, dot DC. And now we can enter the speed or the duty cycle, the power that we give to the motor from minus 100 to 100. We can enter 100. And then the motor would start as soon as we start the program with a speed of 100. We can enter 0, then the motor would stop. Or we can enter minus 100 to turn it into the other direction. In my case, 100 is fine. So I will let it move with 100. And maybe you can program a bit of Python. Then you could think of your own ways for your own programs. Maybe you want to have a flashing light for a warning symbol or stuff like that, then you can include that here. So it doesn't have to be a dump battery box. You can program flashing lights or acceleration curves or stuff like that. That's up to you. I will write a simple program that only starts the motor. And last, I will add a bit of code that does nothing because I don't want to risk that the program stops. So this way we have a loop. So it always repeats this command, and this command does nothing. So the rest of the code doesn't do anything, or it does something, but it does nothing, if that makes sense. Anyways, now we have the program. We don't need the second motor, so I can delete that line. And now I can upload the program to the hub. I will have to put the hub into the update mode, and that can be done by pressing the green button until the purple light blinks. So now it's in update mode, and now I can press this button and I can connect the hub, and then it will get into the update loop. The light will shine in different colors, and in the program, this ring intensifies. Or make sure to disconnect every device, every powered up device, every motor or every sensor from the hub, because that would interfere with the update mode, especially for this app. And if you want to upload the old firmware to the hub, then you can turn the hub back into the update mode. So you can press this button again until it starts to blink purple. Make sure to disconnect everything, and then you can update it with the powered up app, and then you would have the normal Lego firmware with all of its features. And you have to store the program every time you change something in the program again, so you have to upload the firmware again if you want to store a changed or a program with new stuff on the hub. You can also connect the hub if the Pybricks firmware is installed on it with this button, but that's only if you want to develop stuff in Pybricks. Now it's almost finished. The circle is almost full. And now it's finished. So now I could connect the program or the Pybricks environment, the IDE, the Pybricks coding environment, to this hub, and then I could test my own programs, but restore the program that's currently in the editor on this hub. So now we have this simple battery box program on the hub. But first I will turn it off. Then I will plug the motor into the hub. In port B, because in the program I said that it would be in port B. And now I can turn the hub on. I might have to wait a few seconds for the hub to recognize the motor. And then I can press the button again. And the motor starts, and I can start and stop the motor by pressing the green button. And there's no Bluetooth connection or stuff like that. The program is stored in this hub itself, so I don't need any additional connections. That was it for this video on how to create a simple battery box with Pybricks for the current powered up hubs. A simple way to save 35 euros for this battery box, and you can use these hubs in the future for other things, so you can write more complicated programs in the future. And this was only the very simple program. Keep in mind that you can try to control the motors with the sensor or with other sensors, or you can use the sensors in this hub, the rotation sensors, or the gyroscope and stuff like that to change the behavior of the motor. Was this video helpful for you? If yes, please subscribe to the channel and feel free to ask me if you've got any more questions on how to program some stuff in Pybricks, because I'm sure that there might be many other use cases where this might be helpful. Oh, and you can turn this hub off by pressing the green button until the LED stops to blink. I think that I've told everything important. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video, and bye.